How you doing? My name is Thunder, and welcome to part 7 of Auto Metalista. You notice I kind of skipped a little bit ahead, just getting right to the Auto Metalista Championship here, because you'll see the car anyways just right about now. So when you finish the Hill Championship in level 6 for a second time, you get this car, the Dome Giotto Caspita, or something like that. I don't even know if I'm saying it properly, but whatever. This thing's all full tuned, it's all ready to go. This thing makes over 840 horsepower, which is insane. And you will see how insane it is, because I did some testing off screen for this, because of the test run stuff you can do. You'll see how insane this car is when we take it on for the Auto Metalista Championship. 10 star technical rating, 7 races to go. First up, US Speedway. Okay. I'm just actually checking common here, because someone said something about the Mitsuoko Orochi, because it shows up in part 3. Not surprising. The Tuggle? What the hell? The title of the ugliest sports car ever built. It's... Wow, yeah, I definitely agree with that. That thing is just painful for me to look at. I'm sorry, it's just not a good-looking car, in my opinion. But anyways. Now that that's out of the way, I can just focus on the race. You can see this car here is no slouch. It easily gets well up to speed. In fact, most of the time on this track, I don't even need to hit 6th gear because it's just that fast. I could probably put like an acceleration build on it for the next track, and I'd probably still kick the everybody else's asses, including the two cars I'm coming up to. That blue Ford GT, which is still a car we haven't gotten yet, and another Caspita here, which actually is doing pretty well. I'd say better than last time, actually, to be honest. I say last time, but what do I mean last time? I was gonna say better than last time. I haven't done this one yet. Wow, my brain dirt there. I was thinking about the Cobra. I think I was thinking about the Cobra from level 6. Because the Cobra was doing okay, but I think I was thinking, oh, it's doing better now. I was like, no, it's not even the same car. It's not even the same car. I still have to keep my perfect run going here. And ease up on there. I really wish that corner area there wasn't so as sharp as it is, but eh, whatever. Okay, easy around here. I'll just let it kind of coast along here. Barely putting any steering control there. Seemed to have worked. It's like a constant 130 mile an hour drift. And then, of course, the tighter corner, which can't really do it at 130. Yeah, that was a pretty good lap, I'd say. Still slower, though. Jeez. Really? Anyways, last lap here, though. Because, you know, short track. Okay, here we go. Down to the big straightaway for the last time on this. And ease up. Come on, stop the sliding, please. Thank you. And bam, there we go, 35.465, not bad. But we got the win and keep our streak going. Anyways. Okay. I don't actually know why I don't have much to say right now. I'm just trying to think of, I guess my brain's just a little fried. Who knows? I don't know. But anyways, next up is West Tokyo. So let's go. Alright, here we go. Let's put the power down and hope for the best. Of course, it's just all they go all the way from me and then suddenly their little boosting stops kicking in, and then I slowly start to overtake them all. Like, just got the Skyline, now I can do the NSX, and there we go. Now I just got the Viper coming up here. Not a problem. Yeah, even with this being like the big championship, this is still only 3 laps of a track, and this track only takes about just shy of over a minute to do on a rolling start per lap. So it's like, yeah, it's like really, that's all the laps you're gonna give us? It makes it pretty short. This game is just really short. Like, if you really wanted to sit through this game and you didn't care about getting every single thing and you just wanted to do this the fastest way possible, you could. This game would only take you about maybe 2 hours. Probably around there somewhere. It's just such a short game. So it's kind of disappointing, but whatever. It's definitely one of the shortest LPs I've done so far, but it is one part longer than Crash Bandicoot, but still. With Crash Bandicoot, I was just going for show all the levels until the boss, and then, you know, it's the same. And then, you know, with Automalisa here, she's showing all the actual levels, which there are 7 of, so that's what gives it the little edge over, Crash Bandicoot. But yeah, it's definitely one of the shorter ones, that's for sure. Oh boy. Seems to have had a Nash lately. It was TXR2 that kind of broke the mold, but mostly had kind of a thing going on with that, with playing some shorter games, because Colin McRae Rally and Blur and all those kind of things, those ones were only like 10 parts or less. I think like Colin McRae Rally was 9 and then or something, and then Blur was like 10, 8 actually. Yeah, but Automalisa is just another one of those. Yeah, I got it over pretty quick. It's just crazy to think about, but whatever. This is kind of, I guess, what the, I guess how it just happened. I just thought this game was a lot longer than I remember it being, but no, it's quite an awful lot shorter. Oh well, no big deal. I mean, if you want to technically look at this, I'm technically taking this from another person who played this game. I don't know if he did it in full, but the length of this game, you could just consider it like some kind of sort of palate cleanser. Like, if you're doing a bigger game and it's wearing you down, you could just do like this, because it's a shorter game. But, you know. Anyways, we won, and that's the good news. So, next up, boy. Okay, Reverse Osaka Highway. Now, normally, I would actually be adjusting the gears to make this thing go as fast as possible, but I seriously doubt I'm going to even hit top end on this track. So let's just go with what we have. Okay, Osaka Highway. That was really slight. Felt like it was going to be a little bit more, but no, it was a very tiny one. Oh well. Also, this is only 2 laps. I mean, I know it's a little longer than West Tokyo, but barely. Because it's mostly all high speed, so the track's faster than you think. If West Tokyo was this length and it was the same kind of track layout, it would make it longer. But no, this is really not a long track, but you got a car like this doing, let's see. Ooh, managed to get through there perfectly, actually. 226 I just saw there for a split second. 226. This thing just does not give up with its performance. I really want to know what the top end of this car is, but I don't think I'm going to come across it, because there's no track long enough to really find out what this, in this current configuration, what this car will do. Oh well. Okay. Don't worry about that, because I wouldn't, not too much real speed loss, because it just, you know, it doesn't take a lot of effort to get this right back up to its paces. Whoa, that was a little weird of a reaction there, but okay, I'll take it, because the car's still moving. I'm just wondering if I can manage to get this little area here not hitting any walls. Can I do a sub 1 minute? Yeah, I went a little more careful there, but, you know, I still avoided it, so... This may actually be potential. If I just don't do anything stupid, maybe a sub 1 minute could be possible. Maybe. Maybe, though. Oh, God. This is going to be close. This is going to be close. Yes! Got it! 59.799 on Osaka Highway. Sweet. Just got under sub minute. Ooh, that was close. But we did it. Well, that's a positive feeling for me already. Anyways, let's move on to the next one, which is going to be... East Tokyo Fine. Alright, back to some more Tokyo. Just this time East and the Fine variant, because it's dry. Anyways. Alright. Oops. No, don't start in reverse. We don't want that now. I think it's because I think what's causing it is during the little cutscene there, if you press like the shift up or down buttons, it'll still shift the gear, even though you haven't actually started for a second. Whatever. I actually get through those three pretty easily. Just kind of snook through. This can't speed them, man. It's a good car. Alright, ease up. So yeah, so far, actually wait, I'll wait till I get in first, because I don't want to jinx myself. So that GT is in front of the Caspita, just. So yeah, guys, no, the Caspita is actually, wham, it just whacked the wall. I hit it too, but I didn't take as bad of a grunt as he did. But anyways, now that I'm in first, yeah, like, this has so far been a Let's Play where I've not restarted a race and where I've not lost a race, so it's, like, feeling pretty positive about myself right now. Watch out, like, the next track is going to be, like, a U.S. dirt track or something, and it turns out sports radial tires equals this car just walks like an ant. I'm going to be slapping myself in the face if that's exactly what happens, and, like... If one of those two things happens, I'll be like, oh, okay. But if both of them happen, I'll be like, okay, I need to stop being a fucking psychic. Huzzah. Anyways. One more lap to go. Ooh, just poked it. Whatever. Now, if I had to... Actually, wait. No. I'm talking as if I'm on U.S. dirt track, and I don't even know if it's in this championship or not, so... I don't know. What am I... But, well, we'll just see. I'll bring that back up if that track actually does show up. I have no idea what's next, because I haven't played this game in a long time. Anyways. I'm just sounding all awkward, aren't I? But yeah, I'm thinking... Because there's seven tracks, it would have to be... that, and then there would have to also be, like, East Tokyo Rain, and then there'd be, like, there would still be a seventh track, but I'm hoping it's the one that we haven't seen yet, which is in this game, we just haven't seen it in any part, which is surprising, but we'll see. Excuse me. Alright, what do we have next? Oh, god damn it. It is US Dirt Track. Wow. Don't I feel great? Anyways, we gotta go to sports radials for this. I'm not choosing normal because that would probably be a very bad idea. But so yeah, sports radials. Here we go. All right. I'm just praying this car does not go really slowly. Oh boy, that is a badly slow start. Although it may start picking up in pace though. Because I don't think these guys are going to go very fast either. Just, you know, off-roading and everything. I'm coasting along there. Yikes, this car. Come on, move faster. We got to go faster. Come on. Pick it up. Holy. Okay, there's at least one of the cars. Yeah, there's no one's really moving that quick. Except for the other Caspita, though, which is a bit worrying. Oh, wow, the skyline just suddenly slowed down. Yeah, here we go. Ahead of... The Skyline should be doing a lot better. It's a four-wheel drive car, for crying out loud. Come on. See, look at that. The Skyline's suddenly bursting off there. Wow. Is this car really... Am I really just this bad at this track or something? Because even with sports radials, I'm struggling. Like, I'm really trying to push this thing, but I can't really get any faster. I mean, I passed the NSX, I passed the Viper, I passed the Skyline. And I'm trying to get up to this Ford GT, but... I might not have any luck. That other Caspita is way up there. What tires is he on? Like, don't tell me that slicks are the best track for this... Best track, best tires for this track, because, you know... They may be, now that I'm thinking about it. Who knows? Jesus, there's suddenly a Viper. Come on, can I at least get... So it looks like my perfect run's gonna end, because that Caspita's all the way up there! You know what? Fuck. I am just gonna bam right into there to stabilize the car and just go. I am going to... just anything I can do to at least get closer to that other Caspita, I will try to do. And my idea is working so far, actually. This is actually a good idea. You must, like, there has to be some other sort of tires that can make you go that much quicker. I mean, maybe slicks are the best, who knows? Like I said, I'm just doing this because I don't really care anymore. I'm gonna take this win, whether it's the last thing I do. God, look at that thing go, Jesus. Shut up.
You're too slow because you're not driving. Huh, I'm the one doing all the work. Don't be talking about my driving skills. I'll put you in the wall.
Sorry. But anyways. Well, at least my idea worked because now I won somehow. I'll have to do this off screen. Maybe I'll have to find out if slicks are better for this track. Whatever. We won anyway. So that, even though we had to do it a bit of a cheap way, but yeah. And now we come to East Tokyo Rain, so there's no point in even changing the tires. Whew. I had a little bit of heartburn going on right now, which is not fun. But anyways, in the soaking rain. And of course, they take off for first, and then I eventually slowly start to catch up and win. Yeah, maybe I chose the wrong tires for US Dirt Track, but we still kept the streak going. So, whatever. I was just like, you know what, I really want to get a shot at possibly keeping the streak going, so I'm just going to do it a cheap way if I have to, and that's exactly what I did, and it paid off, so. Oh my god, what is, that other Caspita's way up there again, like, what is in that thing this time around? It just, oh no, that wrong... Did not mean to press that button. That was the wrong button to press. I mean, I'll probably still catch up to it, but jeez, why is it suddenly taking off so much better? Is there like some, like, I don't know. Maybe there's just something to this car that I don't know about. I mean, I just bounced off the walls here only because, oh my god, that was actually kind of bad, to be honest. Although it did straighten me out. Lost a lot of speed. Yikes. Come on. Around the bend. Ugh, the handling of this game, you slide around every corner. It's like, where's the grip? Where's the grip? Anyways, we're in the lead now, so. I don't know what has happened to that Caspita. I don't know why it's so much faster all of a sudden. But whatever. Let's just not worry about it and... The smash and bash our way, keeping the lead. Oh no, that was a very bad reaction. Although he's hitting the wall too, so. All right, one more lap to go. Ooh, so bad. That was so bad. Like, holy crap. Oh, well, whatever. As long as we can just keep where we are and then we can just come across as the winner, that's good enough for me. Just please stop sliding through everything, you piece of crap. Piece of crap physics. The car is nice, but piece of crap physics. So, I'm really hoping the track that I have in mind is the one that they give last. Like, if it's just like a reverse, another variant of a track, like forward or reverse, I think it'd be kind of disappointing. But, Oh god, what am I doing? Not paying attention is what I'm doing. Still won, though. If the guy was right in front of me, right behind me, he would have won there, but nope. He had enough distance away from me, so I still won. Okay, one more to go. Oh boy. Please let it be the track of thinking. Yes! There we go. This is the one track we haven't seen through the entirety of the game until now. And there's a little bit more of an interesting bit to this, but here we go with Suzuka Circuit. Alright, so here's a very interesting thing. Okay, now of course this Automalista, this what I'm playing, this is an upgraded version of the game because, you know, the game originally came out in 2002 in Japan and had only Japanese cars and had a few tracks. Suzuka Circuit was one of the tracks, but other tracks such as the US tracks didn't exist. And so, in level 1 of the Freshman's Challenge Cup, instead of the U.S. Speedway, it's Suzuka Circuit. But when they added the extra tracks, they replaced it. And so instead, I guess they decided, let's just make Suzuka Circuit the last track for the upgraded version of the game, which is like, okay, whatever. Have it your way, Capcom. Did I forget to change my tires? I don't know. I may have, but I am still catching up to these people, so it doesn't really... right now, it doesn't really matter. I can't even remember. I may have forgotten. I may have it, but it doesn't matter. I'm still in the lead. I'm not in the lead. I'm second, but, you know, I am catching up to the Cespedes, so... The other one. Come on, because I am definitely not gonna just come all this way to have a perfect run in this game for this LP end with a second place to this guy right here. Not happening. This is also the longest track in the game because Suzuka's a bit of a lengthy track, mostly because of its tight sections and all that stuff. Well, that happened. And here's the very tight section, which I kind of maybe cut just a little bit. Oops. But oh well. Now just kind of relax as I probably just get further and further away from these guys and never worry about them getting up to me unless I do something really stupid. Like right there, for example. Shit. Although I think it's too far away, so it's not going to really matter now. Could just cut through if I wanted to, but I'm not going to do that. Not in the sand areas, that would be terrible, but the grass would probably slow me down too, but probably not as bad as the sand. I'm not even going to try though, so... Also, that's a kind of interesting. You have like a purple Automalista logo that's just right back there. Weird, because you never seen that variant of the logo anywhere else before. So, huh, interesting. All right, come on. Oh, that was actually pretty well done there. Like how I tackled that little area. And around the bend. Oh no. Okay. And coming around. Yeah, I'm just sitting comfortably up here now, so there's no worry about my position being sacrificed unless I just pull off an epic fail. Like, because at this rate, that's kind of what I would have to be doing. So. Okay, bad idea. Bad idea. Again, don't really care. It's because I think I forgot to... It's mostly because I think I... I'm pretty sure I forgot to put the slicks back on. And there we go, 146.9. one more lap to go, and that will be the end of the big championship. Oh! Anyways. Oh! Okay. We're okay. We are okay. Alright. Picking up a little bit of sand there, but because it's only two wheels, I'm not really, it wasn't slowing me down any. Again, pretty nicely done there. Round the big hairpin now. Which I actually did, I think, better than I did last time, which is fine. That came out of nowhere. Okay, come on. Yeah, if I had slicks, I probably could do a lot better around here. I'd probably be ridiculously far ahead. I'm already quite an awful lot ahead right now, but if I had put on the slicks, I probably would have been even more. And even if I did put on the slicks, I'm watching this back and I realize I did, and I am a huge moron, but I'm pretty sure I didn't, so. Alright. Last time around that. And to the finish and the ending of the big Automalista Championship. Woohoo! Yes, huzzah! A perfect run of this game. Oh, that makes me so happy. But anyways. So we got that taken care of. You are the greatest, and we get ourselves the big championship. And we get some items. Which means I have to do this again off screen to get another car. Ah, and as you see, there is no more after this, but so off screen, I'm going to get the last car that I really need, and then there's going to be a little bit of a bonus afterwards, so you're going to want to stay tuned for that when we come to part 8 of Automatalista. But in the meantime, thank you guys for watching, and as always, take care.